Hello, this is Ed Delgado, the National Predictive Services Program Manager at the National Interagency Fire Center in Boise, Idaho, with this month's fire outlook for the months of October, November, December, and January. As we head into the fall months, there's still a considerable amount of dryness across the western parts of the Great Basin and the northern parts of California, where they haven't had much rainfall in about the last 90 to 100 days. So fuel moistures are at record lows and will continue to be so until we get a significant rainfall in that region. So for Northern California, the coastal parts of the state, and also some of the Sierras, and into the western parts of Nevada, we're going to continue to see extreme fire conditions for at least the next couple of weeks into the mid parts of October. And then we'll start to see a moderation as we get the winter precipitation moving into the region. But as we get into November, we'll still see some conditions that are on the dry side across the coastal mountains of Southern California and parts of the Southern Sierras as we get into their downslope and offshore wind season, typically known as the Santa Ana wind season. And that will continue at least through November, and we'll start to see that begin to decrease as we get into December, with only the far southern coastal ranges being affected in that month. By January, most of the West should have substantial amount of precipitation, particularly snow in the mountains and rain along the coastal sections to eliminate most of the fire concerns across the West. We have a lot of below normal conditions across the southern and eastern United States from prolific rainfall throughout the year from a couple of tropical storms and some stalled cold fronts that have brought record amounts to some parts of the mid-Mississippi Valley all the way to the mid-Atlantic coast. And those conditions will mitigate most of their fire concerns throughout the fall and winter season when they typically see an increase in some fire activity. So below normal conditions in the east and the south through the winter, and above normal conditions at least into the early fall and early winter across the western United States.